Okay, this is the Marvel Knights omnibus. It's actually Daredevil, although it doesn't say it on the front cover or the spine. It's mostly by Joe Quesada, who went on to become editor-in-chief at Marvel. I really would have preferred if that said Marvel Knights Daredevil or something, just so when it's on my shelf it says Daredevil in some way. There's a photo of Joe Quesada, which I think this is the only omnibus, certainly the only one I've ever heard of, that has a photo on the back. This collects Daredevil Volume 2, issues 0 to 15, the half issue, Daredevil Father 1 to 6, Marvel Authentics Daredevil number 1, and material from Marvel Knights Double Shot number 1. Take the bus jacket off and you get a pretty cool Joe Quesada image. That's very cool. It's not often you see Daredevil in the day. I like that. So, kicking off volume one, you've got a story by... Ooh, that kind of reminds me of Frank Miller. Oh, yeah, before I start, say this is first print in 2018, because you never know, they may reprint this in the future, and anyone who's looking for reprint content, this isn't for you, but this is the only one at the moment. So it kicks off with Guardian Devil, which is a story by Kevin Smith. There's the image from the board, and that's the same Kevin Smith as in Jay and Silent Bob. And it's an 8-issue story. I love when comics looks like this. Art in the late 90s was just so good. I really wish they would go back to this. Everyone's digital these days, and I don't mind digital colours, but God, this stuff is so good. So Guardian Devil is about this baby that may or may not be the Antichrist. That's very reminiscent of Born Again. Mephisto makes an appearance, I think. Ooh, Doctor Strange looks really cool though. Karen Page. I mean, they couldn't really do a story like that today because AIDS has kind of... The treatment of AIDS... Oh, there's some very cool Mysterio art in here. The treatment of AIDS has evolved so much in the last 20 years that it's no longer a death sentence. So she gets diagnosed with AIDS and she feels like it's the end of the world for her. But today, if you've got AIDS, there is stuff that will hold it back. So a story like this written and released today wouldn't have the same weight to it as it did back then. That's pretty cool. I love that it's got this kind of stained glass border that's reminiscent of a Catholic church. That's got to be David Mack. So this is issues 1 to 15, and the first 8 are Kevin Smith's Guardian Devil. And you'll see throughout the book, like here, different artists do different things. So sometimes David Mack's writing, and sometimes he does the covers. Sometimes he does the pencils, I think. And sometimes Joe Quesada writes, and sometimes Joe Quesada does the pencils. Like, this is clearly David Mack, but this is clearly Joe Quesada. So they had a good little mix. There's no denying David Mack's style, you can't confuse it. So sometimes all of them worked on the covers, like here. And it's very cool to see a team that rotates like that very, very fluidly, and it doesn't feel forced. And it gives the book a good sense of variety without making it feel like it's completely different artists, you know, they're changing artists all the time. That's cool. Here's an example. You can see here, this is signed by Quesada, Palmiotti and Mac. Palmiotti does the inks in this book. So you get a good amount of variety because everybody does different things. This is a very cool story. It's a Punisher story told entirely from the point of view of one of the Punisher's victims' mouth, and you just see him torturing the guy. And then this is Daredevil Father, which was written, and I believe the art was also done by Joe Quesada, and apparently his dad in real life had a massive influence on this book. That looks very cool. That's very, very Dark Knight. God, check that out. The guy's got like a visor on. You don't get that in comics anymore, even in X-Men, you know? I mean, I didn't really like the Gotham TV show, but props to them. They had mutants with visors, and underground mutants should have visors. Not all of them, but some of them. That's cool. Joe Quesada, his artwork varies. It's all good, but it's like his style changes. Which is good, because again, it gives variety to the artwork without making it seem like the entire team has changed. Now, this is Daredevil the Half issue, which was a prequel to Guardian Devil. And I really like the way this is done in like a storybook kind of way, where you get the picture, the border, you get a page writing and a picture. So this would be Matt's origins. This would also be Matt's origins, but again, you get the page of writing and the page of art. This is Daredevil through the years, so you got Man Without Fear Daredevil, original Daredevil, 90s Daredevil, modern Daredevil, Silver Age Daredevil, the first Frank Miller run. Oh, I can't remember what it's called. Born Again, there you go. Nope, sorry, that's also the Frank Miller run. So there's Elektra and Bullseye. This is Born Again. There's a Nuke. That's pretty much, this panel here is taken pretty much straight from a panel, a full page image in Born Again. That's where Matt goes to fight Kingpin the first time. Matt's mum, Ben Urich, who had a really rough time. I've got no idea what these birds are doing here. Maybe that's supposed to be Maggie and that's supposed to be Matt, I don't know. And of course the cross, because it's Daredevil. And that leads straight up to the Mysterio story, so I liked that. Daredevil Zero was an animated comic, because they were quite popular around the turn of the millennium. I used to read Ultimate Spider-Man on the Marvel website. I used to buy the comics as well, but when I went to the site, I discovered that you could read ahead of what was available in the UK, so I loved that. These images are very low resolution because they were designed for something running like Windows 95, 98. And I doubt anybody has the original drawings anymore, so they had to take the crappy compressed ones. So this is Daredevil issue 12. I really don't like this artwork. This is just way too basic, and it's this kind of stuff that I don't like in the Wade run as well. It's just far too basic and it seems lazy to me. Pages like this, you know, if you're going to have a full page, you should at least make it more interesting, put more stuff in it, but there's nothing more here than you get in this panel here. And then you get all the stuff you usually get. Tons of pages. That's a good movie, and if you disagree with me, fuck off. Interviews, sketches. I love seeing sketches because I draw sometimes, and I love seeing the way artists do stuff before it's been inked and coloured. Now this is Marvel Authentics, and I think what they did with this, I've tried googling it and I can't find it, but what it seems to be is they take the pencils, they take the whole issue, and they, as people work on it, it fades through throughout the book. So it starts with just the pencils, then slowly they add the ink in. Then you get the colour palette, then full-on colours, and that's a very cool thing. So I have Superman number one, I think it is, the John Romita one, John Romita Jr. And I've got the director's cut of it as well, and it's very cool to see his original pencils compared to the final version. So Marvel Authentics is that kind of thing. Look at that art, that's awesome. I love seeing Joe Quesada's references as well. Unlike certain Marvel artists, like Salvador La Roca, you can see he hasn't traced them, but he's used references, which is fine. I don't believe tracing should be rewarded. Not in comics. That's Kevin Smith. There's so much art here. Quesada and Mac, Quesada and Mac. See, I love the way the team interacts. Oh, look at that director's cut. I was just talking about that. So there's loads, absolutely loads of stuff in the back of this one. That's it. It's about 700 and something pages, so it's a solid sized omnibus. Not the biggest, but definitely not the smallest. Feels like you get your money's worth, because the art is good, the story I haven't read but I hear is good, and you know, this is issue 0-15, and the Brian Michael Bendis book starts at issue 16. This is volume 1 of Bendis. You see, issue 16. So this runs straight into this. And that's how I like my Omniboo to be. So that's my overview for the Marvel Knights by Joe Quesada Omnibus. Hope you enjoyed it.